Good afternoon, Farbod, David, and
Evening.
Tom. Farbod's coming from the lab where he's working on Tom Campbell's experiments, and I understand that you have had some unusual procedures you've had to go through, but some good news as well. Please, could you tell us about that?
Thank you. Hi, Dana. Hi, everyone. So I didn't have access to the lab for the month of January because of the COVID restrictions. And recently I got access again back. I'm back to the lab. So that's a good thing because there was a lot of approval and procedure involved in to get access again to the lab. And but when I started, I had to move because we are sharing this lab. So I had to move from one side to the other side. So I moved, I'm setting up everything on the other side of the lab because somebody else is going to share that area, one of our other colleagues. So I'm moving here now. This is the kind of same setup, but move to the other side of the lab because that is not that's the area that is assigned to me. I'm working now. Again, I have to align everything. Just started to align everything. The first test that I did is not as good as before. So I'm going through the same procedure like before. And I'm working with the other colleagues because we are also not only doing the experiments for Tom. We also use this setup for education purposes. And I'm working closely with other colleagues who are experts in quantum physics and quantum optics. And we are step by step going again and make sure that the data that we are collecting is very good, is very high standard to the basically level that everybody accepts it. The data that we were getting last time I showed you were very good, but they were not perfect. So I have been kind of advised to make it better, improve the results, data, improve my data. And when I talk to other colleagues, and that's what they suggested, and they are helping me from other universities, other expert physicists. They're telling me how to do, and I contact them, I ask them for advice and help, and they are very helpful and helping me to improve the basically data that we are getting. So yeah, I just, again, as I said, back to the lab and trying to go through all the setup again because I had to move also, and also improving the results. So that's what's going on now.
Well, welcome back, Farbod. This is the first time I've seen you in the lab for a month. Yes. We have just been dead in the water for the last month because of COVID shutting down the facility in Pomona.
Yeah.
We're back, and now it's going to be probably a week or so before you get back to where you were when the plug was pulled. I mean, it's not going to be just a few hours to get all that back again. It's going to take. That was a result of a lot of months worth of collective work to get to where we were before. And it's not going to take that long to do it again, but
no, hopefully
it's going to take a week or two to get everything back up and running again. It surprises me that they've decided to share lab space with you.
We always shared the lab here, but the thing is, I was lucky that they were not available, other colleagues. Because of COVID, they were not available. So I was using the whole space and as I wanted, however I wanted. But now they say, okay, we want our space. So you have to corner.
Okay.
So it's not that flexible as before. The lab is less space for me.
Okay. But it will be enough space. Our experiment doesn't take up a whole lot of space. We're pretty compact. So that should work well.
It should be.
Well, Farbod, I know that you'll get back on track soon and hopefully get back to the experiments, but it's very good news that you have a lot of other universities working with you for your education project, even Oxford. So that's really wonderful and exciting news. Yeah. And thank you for allowing me to be here and update to CUSAC.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
Oh, you're welcome, Donna. Not much of an update. Well, what we did last month was nothing because we got shut out of the lab. But not a very exciting update, but the good news is we're back in the saddle and we're going to start moving again. So guys out there wondering, you know, how are we doing? How much progress have we made? Well, not much since the last time we talked to you, but we're back at it again. And we'll be a lot faster to get it up to where we were. Just a couple of weeks, we'll be back and hopefully making more progress. So my hopes are soaring again. We will hopefully see some good results sometime toward the end of this month and next month that will getting us close. As I recall, where we were before you got locked out was we were thinking a month or two, we may have our first set of results out. Yeah. And so maybe in another month or two and maybe in a half, maybe we'll be back there again. So let's hope so.
Well, thank you Donna. All again.
Thank you for coming by. I keep hearing these things out on the internet that says, what's going on with those experiments? I haven't heard a thing.
Uh-huh.
You know, okay, it's like, well, hey guys, every month we put something out, you know, to tell you.
All right. We'll try to hang in there. And thank you all for allowing me to come in and take up your time. I know you all are very busy. Thanks very much.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Donna.